Joe Judge obviously has been hired as the head coach of the New York Giants. Either everybody was so off base leading into this that the Giants didn't really want Matt Rhule and that the Giants really didn't want Mike McCarthy, that this was the guy all along. But there's no way they knew that this was the guy all along. He comes highly recommended from Bill Belichick. And one thing I will not do, I don't know what Don will do, I don't know what Peter will do. I'm not going to sit here, and I'm not going to be a phony, and I'm not going to say, Joe Judge, how could you hire Joe Judge? He's going to be a terrible... I have no idea what kind of coach Joe Judge is going to be. He's a 38-year-old who's had a background with Nick Saban and with Bill Belichick. He's been in the Patriot organization since 2012, so that's a long time and a lot of Super Bowls. And he's been their special teams coordinator and also their wide receivers coach. All of that we know. We don't know much else about him. Young coach, is it a gamble? Yeah. But I said this earlier, and I truly believe it. Matt Rhule would have been a gamble too. At least this guy's been around NFL players for the last 10 years. Not the case with Matt Rhule. 1 year. And the deal that Matt Rhule got from the Carolina Panthers is stunning to me. Stunning. The fact that the Giants might have choked on that, I don't blame him. I don't blame him. And he got total control of the 53-man roster with the Carolina Panthers. I'm not sure, Don, that even if I wanted Matt Rhule, if I'm the Giants, I would have given him that. I just don't know how you do that with a total neophyte who's coached at Temple right. and in Baylor. Those are not big-time programs.
Well, you look at it at the surface. Why would you not hire Mike McCarthy? Why would you not hire Rhule? Those guys would want more control than maybe the Giants are willing to give.
Although Mike McCarthy got no control in Dallas.
Right.
None.
But maybe he would have wanted it in, with New York. I don't know. If there is an anti-Gettleman sentiment around the NFL where he's a tough guy to work with, nobody wants to work with this guy, then why would you limit your chances to bring in a big-time head coach to keep Gettleman that really hasn't done anything here anyway? Now, I don't think he deserved to be fired. He did draft Jones. His draft wasn't miserable. But if I want to get Mike McCarthy, if I want to get Matt Rhule, and I can't because I've got Dave Gettleman, then you know what? I got to part ways with Dave Gettleman. He's 67 years old anyway. He's not like he's going to have the job for the next 20 years. Why are you so married to Dave Gettleman where it's going to limit your chances of getting other coaches? I wouldn't allow that to happen. Now, the other side of it is, did they just love Judge? Everybody got it wrong. They weren't interested in McCarthy. They weren't interested in Rhule. They weren't interested in anybody else, Martindale, any of the other guys. This was their target. He's somebody from the Bill Belichick background. He's got connections to the Giants organization. They wanted to bring him in. Why would you bring somebody in with zero head coaching experience after you whiffed miserably your last two hires? Wouldn't you want someone with a little bit more of an NFL resume? Can you afford to get it wrong a third consecutive time?
I'll tell you this. I'll take Joe Judge over the amount of money that Matt Rhule's getting. I'm sorry. I could not, with good conscience, give Matt Rhule $9 million a year.
But
I'm sorry.
Money shouldn't be the issue, though, Peter. I hear what you're
saying. I get it.
Too much. The fact that you're giving a total neophyte total control of football operations, to me, that's stunning. Forget about Dave Gettleman. If Dave Gettleman cost you the opportunity to talk with other people, that's problematic. But Matt Rhule, I'm going to turn my franchise over to Matt Rhule?
Completely. 100%.
Completely.
And you're jumping so into bed. I mean, $70 million. I understand the money doesn't matter. It's not our money, but it's about what that shows.
Right.
The desperation to have Matt Rhule run your team.
$70 million and the $15 you have to pay Baylor. I mean, think about it.
But
think
if that's
about
your
David
guy,
Tepper
but
did.
But again,
insane.
This is not capped money. The Giants have a lot of cash. If that's the guy that you love, you're literally putting your money where your mouth is and saying, I don't care how much, this is the guy that we want. So if you loved him, but you know what, I'm not paying $70 million, then what are you doing?
It's still just a sign of being foolish, though, to do that for Matt Rhule. You don't back up the truck for someone who's proved it at the level he's proved it at. Sorry. To me, Temple and Baylor is not enough to back up the truck.
And 1 year in the NFL. One year in the NFL as an assistant offensive line coach for Tom Coughlin and the Giants. Listen, I've been dubious on Matt Rhule, even last week. Since we've come back, I didn't get the obsession with him. Obviously, the Panthers did. David Tepper would not leave the house unless he got an agreement. And there are reports out there that Rhule did call the Giants. Yeah. And this is what I have. I mean, and the Giants, maybe the Giants got scared off by the money. Maybe the Giants got scared off by giving this guy total control.
I couldn't tell if it was that or if when he called the Giants, it sounded like the Giants said, we have another person we're very interested in. Did he balk when he heard that? Because right. He's like, well, I got a sure thing right here in Carolina. I'm not playing your reindeer games with Joe Judge.
When you think about it, Bill Belichick makes $10 million a year. You get it, with incentives, that's what this guy's going to make.
Yeah,
Carolina.
It's unbelievable.
It was a name that we had heard for the last couple of years, especially last year when the Jets were interested, and he was interested in the Jets, and it fell through because of a little bit of a power struggle. I never heard Joe Judge being anybody that was talked about as this hot assistant that needs a job. Did you?
No.
I mean, he's been here. He's been in the NFL for a while. He's been with the Patriots for a while. He's been connected to two of the biggest coaches in the sport of football, and Saban and Belichick. Has his name been mentioned in the last couple of years as a possible coaching candidate? Now he's the head coach of the Giants.
Zach Cox from NESN, which is, you know, one of the local cable channels in New England or Boston. This is what he got a quote from Bill Belichick back in July about Joe Judge. Joe's a really good coach. Joe does a good job. He's smart. He played quarterback. He played offense, so he has a good offensive background. There are a lot of defensive principles and special teams. He's a good defensive coach, teaching those fundamentals and techniques in the kicking game, but they would carry over to defense. Joe could probably coach any position on the field. He does an excellent job of teaching players. He thinks quickly. The game comes easy to him. He understands concepts and adjustments and fundamental techniques. That's the mark of a good coach. I would definitely put him in that category. So high praise.